A short time ago, I asked Japan's ambassador to Australia, Shingo Yamagami, if Japan was worried and why Japan thinks nuclear is safe, unlike us. Now, bear in mind, Japan, normally extremely diplomatic, it's in the culture, but Ambassador Yamagami couldn't help but still give us a message. We are a worry. Mr. Ambassador, thank you so much for joining me. Australia now supplies close to 70% of Japan's coal, 40% of Japan's gas. But in the past year, I mean, you've got to be worried. You've seen governments here attack coal and gas projects. The federal government hitting the gas industry with more restrictions and costs, including the right to make suppliers break contracts with countries like Japan. You've seen the Queensland government impose a new tax hike on coal. You've seen the New South Wales government tell coal exporters to reserve more coal for Australia. How worried is Japan?
Well, Andrew, you know, as a Japanese ambassador to Australia, I wish I could say no worries, mate. But the reality is, you know, there is a growing concern, especially on the part of Japanese businesses. So the Japanese government has been conveying those their concerns to Australia's friends and colleagues at every level.
But Mr. Ambassador, have you detected any concern from Japanese investors? And you look at that INPEX development, for example, of the field, the Browse Basin off WA, that was $30 billion. Have you noticed any sign of nervousness from Japanese investors about trusting that kind of money in Australia again while we've got this war on coal and gas?
There is a solid bedrock of mutual trust between Australia and Japan. Like I said, at every stage of coal and gas industry development, Japan has been involved. And through this, we have nurtured mutual trust between our two countries, two businesses, and we would like to keep it that way. So yes, there is a concern, but I think, we can work on it together.
I'm glad you're in. You're optimistic. I'm a bit less so. Just finally, Mr. Ambassador, we've banned nuclear energy in Australia. I don't know exactly why. I think it's ridiculous. You've got Japan. It's swinging back to nuclear power. You had the Fukushima reactor being destroyed by an earthquake and tsunami. People panicked and Japan said, we're going to close a lot of these nuclear power stations. Now they're reopening. Can you tell me, why does Japan think nuclear power is safe and useful when so many people in Australia think, oh, it's so dangerous?
Well, first of all, each and every country has its own appropriate energy mix. So it's for every country to decide. But that said, in the case of Japan, we are fully aware of the importance of nuclear energy. There is no other country than Japan being sensitive to the safety of nuclear energy for obvious reason and due to our experience in Fukushima. But if you look at the case of Fukushima, the fact of the matter is Fukushima Daiichi, number one power plant, was the only one who went malfunctioning. There are a number of other nuclear power plants who got just suspended because of earthquake. So the disaster in Fukushima took place because of tsunami, not because of earthquake. And this speaks volume about the concern for the safety on the part of Japanese operators. Of course, we take the lesson of Fukushima seriously, but now, looking at the need for decarbonization and appropriate energy mix, there is no denying the importance of nuclear power plants. So we have already restarted 10 power plants, and we are still, exploring the possibility of restarting, many more. That's where we stand right now.
Well, I just wish we would learn from the Japanese example on this, which seems very pragmatic and evidence-driven rather than scare-driven. Ambassador Shingo Yamagami, thank you so much indeed for your time.
Thank you very much, Andrew, for having me.